Okay, this is the second paper about the Virtis result. I will focus in particular on the results of Virtis-M, so the imaging channel here in the Virtis picture concerning the results of the observation of the nucleus of the comet CG. In particular, I will start, since we are a remote sensing instrument, with the description of the orbits and the viewing geometries that were occurring during the Virtis observation in last August during the MTP6 observation phase. Then I will describe briefly typical Virtis-M images and the reflectance spectra, showing to you on this spectra which kind of spectra indicators we have selected to map the composition variability on the surface of the comet nucleus. And then we show for these spectral indicators, in particular for the this albedo, this infrared spectral slopes, and the organic material band depth, the distribution on the surface of the nucleus. So the observation that I will describe today were taken during August, when the spacecraft was flowing on these so-called pyramid orbits. So these were trajectories almost linear around the nucleus between 150 kilometer distances. So the spatial sampling of our instrument was about 25 meters per pixel at the beginning of August, coming down to about 12.5 meters at the end, at beginning of September. At the same period of time, the solar phase was changing between 30 and 45 degrees. So this is particularly important because all the observations that we have collected during this period of time were taken more or less at the same illumination condition. So this allows us to reduce a lot of photometric effects on the maps that I will show later. These are typical images collected by Virtis. One of these was already shown before. Here I report also the five landing sites which were selected in August by the landing team for the Philae landing. The final selected one was the landing site J. And of these five landing sites, which are both on the top head and on the body of the comet, I will use this point to describe the spectral variability of the comet. Here is the same image at 5 microns. This is the image at in the visible in RGB colors. As was told before, we have a poster about the thermal properties of the nucleus tomorrow. So looking at the full spectrum of the five landing sites, you can see that the typical Churyumov-Gerasimenko nucleus spectra are characterized and visible by a reddening below 1 micron. Then we have a much less lower reddening between 1 and 2.5 micron. And then we have the strong thermal emission starting to about 3.5 micron to 5 micron. If we zoom in the part in reflectance, you can appreciate the variability of the slope in the visible range between 0.5 and 0.8 micron. The same slope changes at around 1 micron up to 1.5 and 10 degrees again up to 2.5 micron. These are the three spectral indicators used to evaluate the colors of the nucleus. And moreover, we are using also the band depth of the organic fissure at 3.2 microns, also remove the thermal contribution on the spectrum. We have to take care of some residual from the calibration. In particular, below 0.4 micron, we have this increase, which could be real or not. We are working on this with Osiris in order to better intercalibrate the two instruments. We are characterized by low signal-to-noise ratio in the visible channel at around 1 micron, so this fissure here could be real or not. We are processing now new observation taken with a longer integration time, and then we have the usual filter junction in the infrared range. Now, concerning the data redundancy, this is the projection of all the pixels collected by Virtis during this August phase, about 2 million spectra we have collected on the nucleus of the comet. This is the cylindrical projection of these points showing to you the redundancy of the data. Here is now it becomes a bit complicated to describe this kind of maps because we are projecting this data on a cylindrical map, but the body that we are considering is not spherical. So we have a degeneration of the grid in some points. In particular, this is the so-called head, and you can see here a lot of redundancy, but also the generation of the grid of the coordinates. This is the body, this is the the bottom plane. All the pixels that we are processing and will show to you are averaged and filtered on this big data set. We have considered only points which have incidence at emission angle below 80 degrees. This is important in order to remove points which were collected with a very oblique geometry. And we have also, moreover, removed all the pixels which were in the shadows. And this is, again, is important to boost the signal-to-noise ratio and to improve the interpretation of the results that I will show. We have done a first analysis to estimate the photometry and remove the photometry from the Virtis images. This is the map of the single scattering albedo at 550 nanometer. You can see that the maximum single scattering albedo is about 6% with an average value of about 4%. But using observation taken at full disk resolution and close to the opposition effect, we have estimated a normal albedo at 0.55 micron of about 6%. More details on this on the Cerniello poster tomorrow. Now, in order to have a better view of these results, we have projected them on the Shape 2 model, which was provided to us by the OSIRIS team. And this is the result of the projection of the albedo map that I showed before on the real surface, on the 3D renderings of the surface. And so you can appreciate how the albedo changes across the different regions of the comet. And in particular, you can see the differences in the neck with respect to the rest of the body and of the head. Concerning the colors, we have done a similar map projection in cylindrical coordinates for the 3D spectral slopes I've shown before. This is the slope between 500 and 800 nanometers. You can see here in units of percent for kilo angstrom the variation of the color on the surface. So higher the value, higher is the slope in the visible, and the maximum slope is observed here around the south plane and on top of the head, while lower slopes, so less red colors, are observed in particular in the neck area, in the active region, and towards the North Pole. If we move in the infrared between 1 and 1.5 micron, we see that the distribution of the color is correlated with the previous one. In general, the slope values are about 50% lower, but we continue to observe the maximum in the same position and the minimum color in more or less in the same region. And in particular, I want to show you that if you focus here on the neck region where the slope is about 4 or 5, we continue to observe the same slope of about 5 also between 1.5 and 2.5 micron. This means that the slopes in the active region has more or less the same value from 1 to 2.5 microns, while higher values are here observed in this region here, close to the much more, where we have more roughness on the surface, where the effect of the shadows could be higher. Concerning the band depth of the 3.2 micron fissure of the organics, this is the distribution. We observe the higher value on the south in the south plane on the bottom of the surface, and also on the head, while the minimum value of the band depth is seen on the active area of the neck and in this region here towards the North Pole. Also, in this case, we have reprojected this data on the real shape model. So this is the visible slope, and this is the organics band depth. So here you can see, you can appreciate how where the slope is lower, the blue region here in the neck, we have also lower value of the organics, but we have also some variability on the rest of the surface. You can see also similar correlation on other regions on the surface of the comet. And this is the same map seen by different viewing geometries. In particular, you can see here on the bottom plane the lower value of the in this region here of the organics correlated here with the color. So in conclusion, Virtis has obtained the first compositional map of the 67 TG nucleus during August-September, when the activity was particularly low. This map can be considered as the starting point to understand the composition, the variability of the composition of the nucleus through the perihelion passage. We have obtained the full coverage of the entire illuminated portion of the surface with spatial resolution between 12 and 25 meters per pixel, with a very high redundancy of the data. The surface of the nucleus appears very, very dark, with a normal albedo of about 6%. Is very rich in organics. You have seen that also in the active area, the band depth have a large value of about 0.5. And appears depleted in water ice, at least at this spatial resolution. As Fabrizio showed before, at the higher spatial resolution, we can be able to discriminate on some specific points the presence of water ice. The higher value of the visible slope is observed across the head and the body, while the active areas on the neck appear less red. And this makes sense because these are more fresh region with respect to the rest of the surface. And the and for what concerns the distribution of the organics, as I told before, we have a very widespread distribution across the entire surface. Thanks a lot.